So I have an annoying problem. I'm trying to keep up with tech news, but I hate having to go to each website and navigate through what I want to see. I'm also getting pushed suggested content and seeing ads everywhere. I thought to myself, wouldn't it be great if there was a way for me to view the content I choose in one place? So this reminded me of a little thing I tried in the early 2000s called RSS. Today, I'll give you an overview of RSS, what it is, and how it works. I'll also show you how easy it is to set up and use. And then I'll share my findings on the current usage and support of it. So let's dive into RSS. RSS, or Really Simple Syndication Feed, is a standardized format used to publish frequently updated content from websites, blogs, news sites, and other online platforms. It allows users to stay informed about the latest updates from multiple sources without having to visit each site individually. RSS has been around since 1999. It was popular around the early 2000s and more recently, the 2010s, until Google killed their popular Google Reader in 2013. Since then, most people have started using social media as their source of news content. But that doesn't mean that RSS has been dead. In fact, it's still widely used as an important form of digital communication. You have probably seen this icon somewhere before. Looks like a Wi-Fi signal on its side. When you see this, it means that your site's content is available in an RSS or XML file. This is what we need to start building our own centralized newsfeed. RSS feeds work by organizing content into a structured XML file that looks something like this. It contains headlines, summaries, and sometimes full text articles. Every time there's a new piece of content published, the file is also updated. With this file, you can then subscribe to the RSS feed using an RSS reader or aggregator. You can think of subscribing to an RSS feed the same way as you would subscribe to a YouTube channel or following someone's social media. Once you're subscribed, your RSS reader regularly checks the feed for updates and fetches new content without you ever having to go to that website. So to start building our centralized newsfeed, we'll need something that can read RSS files. Reader is one of the best RSS readers on macOS. There's almost no argument about it, except that it's a paid application. But in my opinion, it's 100% worth it. As you can see here, I started to build my list of subscriptions. RSS feeds that I have added are organized into specific folders that I created. For example, for tech news, I've added feeds from Ars Technica, Gizmodo, TechCrunch, and The Verge. When I click on the folder, I can see all the recent posts. If I want to read the full article or see details, I can then click on the headline. If I want to go to the original page of the post, I can just click on the title. I've also discovered that you can subscribe to YouTube channels using RSS. It's a really neat way to see updates from my favorite channels without having to go to YouTube. Even Reddit is available in RSS. Basically, we are able to find that RSS feeds are supported and available on many popular platforms and websites. If it isn't supported, there are some workarounds, which I'll talk about later. So let's go through and set up a new subscription in Reader so you can see how easy it is. Let's say I want to create a new folder specifically for world news headlines and subscribe to the New York Times. First, I have to find if the New York Times provides RSS feeds. Let's Google it. So you can see that the New York Times actually provides several different feeds. I just want all the headlines from the front page, so I'm just going to copy their RSS link and paste it into the subscribe field in Reader. Click search and the reader will validate if it's an RSS feed, then let you add to a specific folder. I created a new folder for World News, selected it, and subscribed. Since the New York Times offers specific sections, Let's say I just want to subscribe to their personal tech news and have it be in my folder with all my other tech news feeds. I do the same thing, select my tech news folder, and subscribe. So now that I have my feed set up, I can just read whenever I want. It works like an email inbox, so new posts will get marked as read when I click on them, and then I can also filter things I haven't read or mark things I'll read later. I've set up my feeds to refresh hourly, but they can also be manually refreshed. So now that you know how it works and how to use it, I'll go over some of the questions you might have about its use and support. So first, why is RSS not widely used? The rise of social media, where people now rely on their social media for news. Second, the existence of content aggregators like Google and Apple News, where users can get curated and personalized content based on their interests. Third, the general lack of awareness and familiarity because average users haven't been exposed to it or are unaware of its benefits. And fourth, there's little incentive for content providers to push or make their RSS feeds available since there's no advertising or monetization. Is RSS dying out? RSS is not dying. It's actually still being used today. Podcasters use RSS feeds to distribute their podcasts to directories like Apple, Google, and Spotify. Aside from podcasts, RSS is utilized by journalists, researchers, and analysts to monitor news in specific industries or areas of interest. What if a website doesn't have an RSS feed? It's possible that you won't find an RSS feed available. If that's the case, you can try using a generator to make a feed for you. So to recap, here's why you should be using RSS today. You can customize your own feed by directly subscribing to the content you want. Save time by receiving updates into one consolidated place. Have privacy and control by accessing content directly instead of going to multiple websites. And there are no ads or recommended content to waste my time. If you wanted to start using RSS feeds today, here are a couple places I recommend to start building your feeds. The easiest to start with are cloud-based readers. Feedly is one of the most popular readers. It is accessible by browser and available on apps. Its free subscription allows you to create 3 folders and have up to 100 feeds. You can also look at their AI feeds to track specific topics and industries. InnoReader is another great reader that gives a free tier with up to 150 feeds. For Mac and iOS, Reader is hands down the best, even though it's a one-time paid software. It has iCloud Sync if you are switching between iOS and Mac. NetNewsWire is a great open source alternative for a Mac OS reader. It's very comparable to Reader, and best of all, it's free. Reader is only slightly better because of its better user interface. And if you're on PC, look into Newsflow. So it's time for some final thoughts. I feel like content consumption has become quite overwhelming and tiring. There's just so much content spread across the web, and we often don't have time to seek and manage multiple sources. I think that's why I found myself sticking with what's in front of me, either what I bookmarked or just going to an aggregator like Google News. By using RSS feeds, I feel like I've regained control of my content consumption, and I have a much more pleasant reading experience instead of being inundated with ads and suggested content. The biggest concern I see for RSS is if large websites and platforms decide to finally drop support for it. But I really have a hard time seeing that as a possibility since it's been a standard web communication for so long. So what did you think of RSS? Have you thought about using it or maybe even revisiting it? I think it's time for an RSS comeback. Don't you agree? Comment down below what you think. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, And subscribe if you want to see more videos in innovative tech. I'm Jeff, and see you in the next one.